Hello, my name is Biao Xu. We are from the research group of Human Mobility Automation, Zhejiang University. Professor Dao Feili is the director of our group. Mr. Ning Huichen and Mr. Jian Kanhu are two other group members contributing to this work. I'm honored to present our research on automated car following algorithm considering passenger motion sickness. Today's presentation is divided into the following six parts. Background and related work, motivation and framework, modeling, controller design, simulation results, and conclusion. The first part is background and related work. Car sickness is one of the most common forms of motion sickness. It obviously leads to uncomfortable rides. Car following in congested urban traffic is one of the most common conditions in daily driving, which is also easier to cause passenger motion sickness than most driving in night traffic. The picture on the right is a typical scenario of car following conditions. So for more comfortable rides, it is necessary to design an automatic car following algorithm that can mitigate passenger motion sickness. In recent years, there are many two kinds of methods to mitigate passenger motion sickness. One of them is optimizing the layout of the cabin environment and the user interfaces, which use the front view of the vehicle as the screen background when reading. Previously, we also proposed vibration cue system to inform the upcoming motion to mitigate passenger motion sickness. Another method is trajectory planning methods. Yukita minimized motion sickness for the lane change task through trajectory planning and the steering controller improvements. Hattick proposed an optimal control method that considers motion sickness to implement an improved motion planning approach. However, there are few researches on mitigating passenger motion sickness in car following scenario. Our study will make efforts in this regard. Then, we will introduce our motivation and the framework to carry out in this study. Model predictive control is one of the most widely used control algorithms in automated car following. General structure of automated car following algorithm based on MPC is shown in the picture. The vehicle longitudinal dynamics model and the car following model are established as the predictive model in the model predictive controller. The current driving state of the ego car and the front car are received as state feedback, and the rolling optimization method is used to obtain the optimal control output at each moment. In order to improve ride comfort, the existing MPC car following algorithms mostly use jerk or acceleration as optimization targets. So we hope to propose an automated car following algorithm which uses not only jerk but also passenger motion sickness as optimization targets. And the general MPC car following algorithm is used as benchmark algorithm to verify the effectiveness of the proposed algorithm. The structure of the automated car following algorithm that considers passenger motion sickness is shown in the picture. Compared with the benchmark algorithm, a passenger motion sickness model is added to the prediction model to establish a human vehicle system model, and since the rotation of the sprung mass of vehicle also has a certain stimulating effect on the passenger motion sickness, the pitch model of the vehicle based on the longitudinal dynamics is added as the input of the motion sickness model. The current driving state of the ego car and the front car and the real-time motion sickness of the passengers are received as state feedback, and the rolling optimization method is used to obtain the optimal control output at each moment. Due to the true state of passenger motion sickness under simulation conditions cannot be obtained, the calculation results of the passenger motion sickness model are used to replace the actual state of motion sickness of passengers in the simulation analysis. In summary, the human vehicle environment system is established. Then we will introduce the models in the proposed algorithm. The first model is motion sickness model. WADA gave the structure of the six-stop SVC as shown in picture. The main body of the model is divided into two parts. The upper part can calculate the perceived vertical. The semicircular coils receive rotation angular velocity, and the otoliths receive translation acceleration. The part framed by the dotted line is an internal model of human brain based on previous experience. It makes a prediction or estimation of the vertical and calculates the subjective vertical. Finally, the subjective vertical conflict can be obtained. Then the model uses the Hare function and the second order integrator to map the subjective vertical conflict to the motion sickness incidence. The details of the G module and LP module are shown in equation 1 and equation 2 respectively. The second model is longitudinal dynamics model. The experimental vehicle is an entry-level SUV and has integrated a chassis by wire system. This study mainly carries out the actual vehicle acceleration response test at a speed of 20 km per hour. The established transfer function model is fitted with the vehicle tests as shown in the picture. The transfer function models for driving and braking acceleration response are established as equation 3 and 4, respectively. In congested traffic driving, the pitch motion in car following should be considered. For simplicity, the pitch angle and the pitch rate are mainly affected by the longitudinal acceleration. The simplified pitch dynamic model is established as equation 5. A second-order transfer function from longitudinal acceleration to pitch angle is shown in equation 6, AX, phi, and the right figure. The fourth model is longitudinal car following model. The picture is a typical scenario of car following condition. Assuming that the positions of the ego car and the front car are X and XH respectively, there is the head-to-head distance delta X equals XH minus X. V and VH are the speeds of the ego car and the front car, and AX, AH are the accelerations of the ego car and the front car respectively. According to kinematics, we have the equation 7. The next part is the controller design. In view of the inconsistency of vehicle dynamic response in acceleration and deceleration, it is assumed that the driving and braking parts are independent and don't interface with each other. Then the vehicle longitudinal acceleration AX equals AP plus AN. Combining the vehicle model and motion sickness model, we can get the human vehicle environment system model as seen in equation 8. Then, linearizing equation 8 at the nominal state of the human vehicle environment system at time t0, we can obtain the linear state equation 9. A and B are the Jacobian matrix. The first order discretization of equation 9 is shown in equation 10. Considering that the vehicle acceleration response has a pure delay of 0.3 seconds, we multiply e to the minus 0.3 seconds into the transfer function. To achieve the accurate car following performance and also to reduce the motion sickness, the cost function is designed as in equation 11, where reference y are expected following distance, expected speed, expected jerk, and three excess components of expected subjective vertical deviation, respectively. QR are the width of the system, output error, and the control respectively. Epsilon is a relaxation factor. The first term of the cost function represents the accuracy performance of car following and the passenger MSI, while the second term represents the limitation of control energy, hoping to reduce the overall control energy. The last term is used to ensure that the objective function has a feasible solution. To ensure stable car following control and ensure that the output doesn't exceed the limit of control command, the constraints in equation 12 are made on the outputs and the rate of change of the outputs. Delta X is the head-to-head distance between the ego car and the front car. AX .ax, v, up, and un are the acceleration, jerk, speed, driving acceleration, and braking acceleration of the EO car, respectively. Delta up and delta un are the difference between the acceleration of two adjacent steps. Then, we will present the simulation results. To simulate the challenging driving conditions for motion sickness, we extract a 340 seconds segment of longitudinal acceleration of a real car driving in congested traffic condition, shown in the picture. By repeating these segments cyclically, we compose a 1800 seconds cycle of front car acceleration excitation. At the initial moment, the speeds of both the ego and the front car are 5 meters per second, and the initial time headway between the two vehicles is 2 seconds. As shown in Figure A, it can be found that the two algorithms have low adverse difference in the car following distance error, and both can maintain the time headway close to 2 seconds. So, the proposed algorithm has the basic ability to keep stable when following the front car. In terms of following distance error, the proposed algorithm is slightly smaller than the benchmark algorithm, but the partial jerk of the following distance error of the proposed algorithm is more obvious. The reason can be obtained from the simulation results of the jerk, as shown in Figure B. It is obvious that the jerk of the vehicle under the control of the proposed algorithm is larger. Figure C and Table D summarize the three ride comfort indexes with the two algorithms. For car following, it is generally believed that the jerk magnitude can be used to indicate some certain aspects of the ride comfort. Results show that the RM jerk of the proposed algorithm is 0.66 meters per cubic second, which is slightly bigger than that of the benchmark algorithm. However, for such low magnitude of jerk, this slight difference is not perceivable for passengers, since the maximum magnitude of jerk that can be tolerated without undue discomfort is 10 meters per cubic second. From the point of view of motion sickness, the proposed algorithm can effectively reduce both MSI and MSDV. The MSI index of the benchmark algorithm is 0.36%, and that of the proposed algorithm is 0.33%, showing a reduction percentage of 7.3%. The MSDV index of the proposed algorithm is 9.48, while the MSDV index of the benchmark algorithm is 10.06, showing a reduction percentage of 5.8%. Therefore, the proposed algorithm can effectively reduce passenger motion sickness from the simulation results. Finally, we can get the conclusion. The passenger motion sickness model and the car following model are combined to establish a human vehicle environment system model. We propose an automated car following algorithm considering passenger motion sickness using model predictive control. We can conclude from simulation results that the proposed algorithm can effectively reduce passenger motion sickness while without sacrificing the car following safety. This research is supported by Ningbo Science and Technology Bureau, Department of Science and Technology of Zhejiang. Thank you for watching.